Hey everybody, and welcome back to SnowRunner. Continuing our gameplay here on Zimnegorsk, whatever it is. And, got our Dan. The truck we recovered over at the quarry. Got it equipped with some mud tires, did some upgrades to it, and various things. And man, this is one long truck. We're going to use it to basically do the pier recovery mission. Recovery is something that popped up after we basically did the bridge recovery. And we basically have to come down here with oversized cargo and two more concrete slabs to repair broken pier. And as a result, we will then unlock two locations. Gonna haul the oversized cargo first. With the Dan, see how this truck does. A little apprehensive given its length. I have a pretty big turning radius. Big old semi-trailer. But we've got all-wheel drive and stiff locks. Hopefully, they'll get through the ground fairly well. Biggest question is going to be ground clearance. How well will we be able to get through things like boulders, other stuff that's on the ground. Of course, the ever present turning radius. Difficulties with this particular truck. Long truck. Trying to figure out what trailer would be best to use for this truck and everything, and I don't know if it would be better using a high saddle trailer. Looked like that came up a little further on the chassis. It would make the truck overall a little shorter. Truck didn't look quite right with standard sideboard trailer on it. Plus for this job I need four trailer slots. so far. Turn here. Truck's proving its worth. It's such a long truck. Truck length, really? Seems to be putting this trailer at fair bit of risk. The range here. This is a car we gotta recover. I'm going to give this truck a try. I don't know. Maybe it'd be better if it wasn't pulling a big long trailer. No? So, I want to. One thing I'm going to do is went this way with this truck and this trailer. This is the off-road sideboard trailer we've been using. I'm going to, once we deliver this, I'm going to jump in the Voltron, basically the truck we've been using with this trailer. I'm going to go once again, pick up the concrete, and bring it this exact path. I want to see what kind of, how does that truck go through that road? And quite frankly, I think that truck is just going to eat it up. Spin it out. I don't think this truck has the suspension height really to deal with this deep mud. So long after you factor in the length of the trailer and where the trailer attaches to this truck. I got to question what the practicality of this truck is, other than being a straight truck with like a sideboard trailer or other modules like a crane module. I'm sure this truck would make a great heavy crane. So long. Pivot point so far back, trailer really makes, trailer doesn't track behind the truck very well. No? But the truck's almost as long as the trailer is. But then the pivot point's in the middle of the entire length. I'm gonna park this here. Back to our garage. The off-road. Run it. Now let's head back to quarry and get two more slabs of concrete. And I'll bring it back once we get concrete and get back here to Zimnegorsk. So I've got the concrete and I came back here to the garage just to refuel the truck. Head back the exact same way we took the oversized cargo with the other truck and just see. How does this truck take to that road? Pulling the same trailer. Different load, of course. I actually plan on rectifying that situation with the next pass that we're going to do. There is a sawmill recovery. We need to bring oversized cargo. And we'll use this truck. Angled there, but I wasn't as concerned tipping as I was with the other truck. Getting a little bogged down in the mud, but not too bad. Make this turn. That other truck does have some more winch points. Okay, with that it has two more winch points on the body of the truck. I think this. Concrete slabs is heavier cargo. Thought I was in low range, but I wasn't. Fruit is pretty good mud. Made up pretty good mud here. Daylight on the situation. There is one bridge I would like to see get fixed on this map. A little further up the river than the bridge that we fixed. Make trips like this over here to the pier a whole lot easier. No, we want to go. I'm glad I refueled the truck, because when we got back from getting the concrete, we only had 37 gallons in the truck. Now we're down to 35 gallons. Couldn't have much fuel left. I'd say other than just the turning radius, both trucks seem to fare fairly well. Could be the same through that area. But I gotta wonder how well they would fare with the same load. I just stopped to grab the screenshot. Thank you. Quick out of the way. Like, just in case there's an animation. Oh, that's pretty neat. Ew. Recovery. Supposedly that unlocked location. Did indeed. Now there's a warehouse up here. Cargo containers. Else. At this point. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the full run back to warehouse up here, and when I do that, I'm going to take the abandoned car. Abandoned car needs to go back to the warehouse. I'm going to clear that. In the next video, we're going to cover the sawmill recovery. We're going to need to do oversized cargo, sawmill, and metal beams. The sawmill, and we'll use the Dan for the metal beams. We'll use the Volrin oversized cargo, and this is the bridge I wish we could fix. That would make getting from this side of the map to this side of the map a bit easier. Yeah, this gives us access to two more locations. Wonder what this is up here. Maybe this will be one of those locations that we need to get to, and maybe this will be a location we need to get to. It's conspicuously large and empty, right? Yeah, that's what we'll do next video. Till next time, keep those wheels on the ground.